Greetings, my dear colleagues, participants and guests of the Asgardia's first Space and Investment Congress. Our Congress is dated to coincide not with the full moon we see today, but with the third anniversary of Asgardia, the first in the world history space nation that we celebrated 2 days ago on October 12th. We are more than 1 million Asgardians in more than 200 countries on Earth. And I would like to take this opportunity to congratulate all the Asgardians on our great national holiday. We have defined 12 main areas of Asgardia's national interests. But it is for a reason that the area of science was chosen as the main one for hosting our first global conference. In doing so, we set the core priority for our nation, long-term space exploration and settlement in space. The roadmap of this endeavor consists of the following three main areas: risks, opportunities, and goals. What is the risks? It would be dangerous to take on this long space journey a huge baggage of earthly problems accumulated over millennia. We simply cannot afford militarization of space by projecting earthly borders onto it. One should realize that only about 20 countries out of 229 have access to space. This is discrimination of space caliber against the countries which are unjustly called the third world countries and against their citizens, and even simpler, against all Earthlings and Asgardians. National space agencies are selfish. They meet the objectives set forth by the governments that finance them, which is only natural. But who should solve the common space problems of humanity as a whole? What are the opportunities? Asgardia is capable of bringing global democracy to space science. Scientists in some countries today are constricted by national legislation, which is often far from freedom of creativity, communication, travel, and has many other limitations. This is unacceptable and unjust to the humankind. Unlike the politically driven antagonistic states on Earth, we are able to step beyond the artificially imposed prohibitions. A significant advantage of Asgardia is its economic model. We do not need to spend our national budget on such traditional earthly budget lines as agriculture, road infrastructure, energy, army, and so on. We can even leave out the pensions now due to the young age of Asgardian population. This means that we can focus almost all the financial resources from the national budget on space, in other words, the most promising high-tech projects. So we are in win-win situation. What are the goals? This brings us to the main visionary and scientific mission of Asgardia, birth of the first human child in space. I will start by brushing aside hypocritical speculation about risks of childbirth for both mother and child. Humanity would have never become what it is today if our wooden vessels did not sail away from their warm or not so warm harbors into the unknown, to the shores which were not seen not only on Google Maps, but on any maps at all. We simply owe this chance to ourselves now, when the planet Earth is pretty much explored and finitude of human existence on Earth is already recognized. All the magnificent projects for settlement on Mars and similar extravaganza are one-way ticket in the absence of the first human child. It goes without saying, of course, that it will happen on the basis of indispensable comprehensive scientific research. Scientifically, this visionary mission rests on the following three pillars: biological viability, artificial gravity, and radiation protection. This is what is reflected in the logo of our Congress and Asgardia as a whole. From the financial point of view, for the benefit of the entire humankind, we will introduce also the concept of the space child tax. The low levels of this scientific pyramid will be holding many scientific investment projects, the number and novelty of which we cannot even imagine today. And this is what Asgardia was created for, to unite the scientists and investors from all over the world for solving the global task of preserving the humankind in the universe. I am stating with the confidence that from now on, the Space Science and Investment Congress of Asgardia will be held regularly. I wish you successful, fruitful work and friendly, constructive networking. Good high-tech technology. Okay, and now I hand over to the president of our Congress, Dr. Floris Weitz, professor at the University of Antwerp, and at the same time the Ministry of Science of Asgardia. Thank you for attention. Mr. Floris, now you will do something with this